Chicken's when you come up?
Savor it. Let it burn it.
Just listen to the. Try to
step on the beat.
On the beat.
Yeah.
Because it needs to be epic, you know?
Epic. I don't know why.
Yeah, why aren't we playing like a Hans Zimmer song?
Yeah. So as soon as you walk out, whenever you, he'll just change the music.
Okay.
We'll play the inception.
Unless you want him to change the music, would that be better?
No, give me a
yeah, don't you have like the lead up to her walking in?
Yeah, that's what I'm listening
to.
Alright, so play the lead up for her right now. Okay. So
this is.
Shorter steps, nice short steps. Short steps. They'll figure
no,
it out.
That's my
people
view.
Know. People
please
know.
Rise.
Oh, there you go.
Please rise, and then I walk out. Right?
Yeah.
All right. We need to take a dollar.
Yes. You say please rise, and that's when Andrew changes the music.
Yes. Okay. Yeah. That's what I was saying.
There we go. Okay. Just walk in with Shay.
Yeah. You walk in with
me. Yeah, because you guys, we're all
right. Upgraded. I'm not here.
You get promoted? That's the Seinfeld bit about that. That's why it's, you take this one. And that's why we're all dressed the same. That way the next person can just step in.
No, I got you right
here. So I say, please rise. Bride to be wed.
I do.
Why'd you deliver that like the troll under the bridge?
I'll hold that hand, but you're in the shake of this hand. Alright? There you go.
There's pass.
Please be seated.
Thank you.
How are you, sir? Looking good, Captain? I will let folks know to kind of at least come into the parking lot, because otherwise...
He walked out and that was great.
Yeah, you're going to have to, otherwise you're going to have to back out. So, yeah.
The rest of the family might not be so...
You know, it's 95% of limo accidents happen in reverse. It's fact.
Interesting. Okay, good. Then see if we can avoid that. Yeah.
The restrooms, if you go out the door, it's past the staircase on your right-hand side. Men's and women's restrooms are over there. When we are done, we're going to go into the banquet hall. We'll go through these white doors over here on the left, not the ones that the bridal party will exit through, okay? So, we can all be seated and get ready. Man your stations. Rise. First, I'd like to begin by welcoming everyone and thanking each and every one of you for being here on this most happy of days. I'd also like to acknowledge family and friends who could not make the trip here today. It's no accident that each of you here today have been chosen because you're important to the individual and collective lives of Cheyenne and Michael. I know how deeply these two care for and love one another. And I feel privileged to be here today among all of you as a witness of their commitment to a lifetime of love for one another. I think I've had the good fortune to meet most of you here today at some point or another, but for those of you who I haven't, my name is Bob Shipley. My wife Andrea and I have been married for 29 years.
Married.
I know I missed that thing. Anyway, I met Michael in the Boy Scout Troop 59 in 2006, and that's when we became accustomed to one another as a family. So, as a family friend, it's been a pleasure to watch Chey and Mike's developing relationship. Their personalities complement one another so well. They both challenge one another to be better versions of themselves. They balance one another, and while each are whole individuals on their own, together they are even better. And the realization that as a couple, they are so much better than when they stood alone is what has ultimately led us here today. We will witness their commitment to one another in front of those that they love most. So without further ado, let's begin. Oh, yes. Let's have a seat. Let's begin to sit down. Dearly beloved and honored guests, we are gathered here to join Cheyenne and Michael in the union of marriage. This contract is not to be entered into lightly, but thoughtfully and seriously, and with a deep realization of its obligations and responsibilities. The bride and groom have each prepared vows that they will read now.
Today is the first day of the rest of our life. With one love and family. Can't wait to spend it with you. I promise to give you my whole being and support your dreams in every way. You've made me a better person, and I would not be the man I am today without your love. I promise to cherish and respect you, to never take your love for granted, and to continue to win you over every day. For you have made me the luckiest man. In the world. Most importantly, I promise to order Taco Bell for you whenever you get those late nightmares.
And now, Cheyenne, do you take Michael to be your husband? Do you promise to love, honor, cherish, and protect him, forsaking all others, and holding only unto him forevermore?
I do.
And Michael, you take Cheyenne to be your wife. do you promise to love, honor, cherish, and protect her, forsaking all others and holding only unto her forevermore?
I do.
All right, I guess we can continue with this. Cheyenne and Michael will now exchange rings as a symbol of love and commitment to each other. Rings are a precious metal. They are also made precious by you wearing them. Perfect. Your wedding rings are special. Don't throw them on the floor. They enhance who you are. They mark the beginning of your long journey together. Your wedding ring is a circle, a symbol of love never ending. It is the seal of the vows you have just taken to love each other without end. Cheyenne, please place the ring on Michael's left hand and repeat after me. As a sign of my love,
that I have chosen you,
above all else,
with this ring I
thee wed. Michael, please place the ring on Cheyenne's left hand and repeat after me. As a sign of my love,
the sign of my love,
that I have chosen you,
that I have chosen you,
above all else,
above all else,
with this ring I thee wed.
With this ring I thee wed.
To make your relationship work will take love, compassion, and patience. Continue to date each other in order to remind one another of your romantic love. Know when to let things go for the sake of one another and so that you can continue to move forward in your marriage. Trust in each other to know that you both are keeping the best interests of your family in your hearts. Persevere through the many challenges you will face as individuals and a family. As long as you move together, you will succeed in the face of all challenges put before you. And above all, it will take commitment to hold true to the journey you have both pledged today. And now, by the power vested in me, by you, you may kiss the bride. I'm pleased to present Cheyenne and Michael Geissler. This door. Don't forget about the signature frame there. And above all else, have fun.
We need him. We need you for pictures.
Yep.
Go.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, friends and loved ones. Welcome to Chey and Mike's wedding reception. My name is Chris, for those of you who don't know me. I'm Mike's older brother, and I've been asked by the couple to be your MC tonight. Mercifully for them, so I don't have to give a toast and roast my older brother, which he never wants to have it here. Now, ladies and gentlemen, it's time for the introduction of our party. Get on your feet, please, as we welcome the party. First, the father of the bride, Mr. Lafferty. You've got more than that, folks. The parents of the groom, Dr. and Mrs. Geissler. They worked all day on that entrance. The best man, in name only, Brian Hayashida. That's the entrance we wanted. Mom and Dad, take notes. Maria Lafferty and Brian Grau. Andrew Shipley. Ella Lafferty and Peter Geppert. And now you've been saving all the big applause and the big cheers for the big bride and couple, our bride and groom, Chey and Mike Geissler. All right, ladies and gentlemen, now I have more good news for you. It is time for dinner. You can take a seat if you're not at table one. Table one, you are dismissed to head over and grab dinner.
Come on, Grandpa. Yeah.
right, ladies and gentlemen, it's time. The dance floor is open. Let's have a great time tonight.
Keep that sword away from the lady.
This is not your ordinary cake cutting, folks.
Take me home, and I know who I want.
right. Good night. Give me a call when you guys are ready for us to pick you up in the morning. Okay. All right. Bye. Thank you, Alan. Well, yee, biddy, biddy, biddy. That's all, folks.